tell us a story.
Pinky's got a story she wants to share with you. Pinky Dinky Doo, never at a loss for words, she pulls out of the blue. Pinky Dinky Doo, her little brother Tyler and Mr. Guinea Pig. Pinky Dinky's always thinking big. Yes, a Rooney positive, zip, zam, zoom. Pinky Dinky Doo, in the great big city with all the Dinky Doos. Pinky makes up stories with fancy words, too. She's always acting silly, and you'll often hear her say,
now that's something you don't see every day.
Little brother Tyler and Mr. Guinea Pig. Pinky Dinky's always thinking big. Yes, a Rooney, Positoony, zip, zam, zoom.
Phew.
Pinky Dinky Doo.
Pinky Dinky Duplicate.
Pinky, I need your help.
What's wrong, Tyler?
I just got a cool new game.
That sounds like a good thing to me.
It would be good if I could play it, but I can't.
Why not?
Because I have to make my bed and put away my toys and clean up my paints. I wish someone else could do my chores.
Wish someone else could do your chores.
That gives me an idea. Pinky, are you gonna make up a story?
Yes, sir. Rooney Positoony.
Yes, sir. Rooney Positoony. We're going to the story box, where Pinky's really good at making up stories, and every story rocks. Story box.
Okay. So one day in Great Big City, Pinky decided to make her very own comic book. But first she wanted to make sure she was totally comfortable. What should I sit on? Should I sit on a great big cactus? Ouch, too sticky. How about a big pile of cheese toast? Nah, still too sticky. Or how about in my very own special chair? Perfect. Now I'm all comfy and ready to start.
Pinky, don't forget to do your homework.
Oh, okay, Mom.
Hey, Pinky, could you please make your bed?
Sure, Dad.
Pinky, could you please help me with lunch? I'm making banana sandwiches, and I can't find the bananas, and I can't find the bread.
Okay.
All of a sudden, Pinky had a million chores to do. How am I gonna get all this done? I know. I have just the thing. I can use my Pinky Dinky Duplicator. And duplicate myself.
Wait a minute, Pinky.
I know that word. Duplicate is when you make a copy of something. So instead of having one, you have two, or three, or four, or... Right-a-rooney, little bro. But you can't... duplicate people.
You can in a made-up story.
Cool!
What happens next?
Let's see. I can use a duplicator to make copies of myself, and the copies can do all my chores. Yes! So Mr. Guinea Pig pressed the start button.
One Pinky, two Pinkies, three Pinkies.
And three crisp new copies of Pinky popped out. Three Pinkies, perfect! You can do my homework.
Okay.
You can make my bed.
Okay.
And you can help Tyler find the bananas.
Okay.
And I can go downstairs and work on my comic book. Perfect. But just as Pinky started to draw...
Pinky, would you mind helping me water the flowers?
Sure, Mom. No problem.
Hey, Pinky, would you help me hang this duck?
Sure, Dad. No problem. Looks like I'll have to
duplicate myself again. Mr. Guinea Pig, would you please go upstairs and make two more pinkies?
Alrighty.
Thanks. So Mr. Guinea Pig hit the start button on the duplicator.
One pinky.
But nothing seemed to happen. So we hit it again.
Two pinkies.
And again.
Three pinkies.
And again.
Four pinkies, five pinkies, many, many pinkies.
And still, nothing, nothing, nothing.
I think the machine's busted.
So Mr. Guinea Pig gave up. But as soon as he left, the duplicator began to pop out pinkies. Lots and lots of pinkies. Each pinky began doing chores. First they did Pinky's homework, then they made Pinky's bed. But there were too many of them, and they began to make a big mess.
Thank you, Pinky.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Pinky.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Pinky.
You're welcome.
Oh, my.
You're welcome. You're welcome. You're welcome. You're welcome. You're welcome.
That's a lot of pinkies.
Uh-oh. Oh, quick! The duplicator made too many pinkies, and now there's big trouble.
What? Oh, no! Teach me to never duplicate myself again.
Pinky, come quick.
Uh-oh. Wow, I'm hungry for lunch, but not this hungry.
Pinky, they just kept making sandwiches. Hey, look at that.
Lunchtime, we're hungry.
Now that's something you don't see every day. What are we gonna do? Looks like it's time for me to think big.
Look out! The pinkies are gonna think big.
If I have a problem, don't know which way to go, I think and think and think and think. And suddenly I know.
Come on, Pink, think!
And then it happened. Pinky had a big idea. Just what to do. Attention all pinkies, follow me. This is a comic book I've been making, but I've only had time to draw Mr. Guinea Pig. You can help me finish it. Who wants to be in my comic book?
Me!
I do great! Okay, everybody, jump in. So all of the pinkies jumped into Pinky's book, finishing the story on the pages. Cool! Now that's a job well done.
Yes-a-roony, positivity!
Pinky!
Uh-oh, sounds like I have some chores to do. So Pinky, zip, zam, zoom, through all her chores. And found that they didn't take as long as she thought after all. Phew! And I'll never duplicate myself again. And that's exactly what happened. Pretty much. The end.
Cool story, Pinky. If I start doing my chores right away, I can get them done in no time.
And you might even have some time left over to play your new game.
Sounds like game time.
Say cheese, please.
Cheese, please.
Let's play a game called Who Said This?
Who said this?
Here are three characters from my made-up story. There's Daddy Dinky Doo, Mr. Guinea Pig, and me, Pinky. Each character is gonna say the same thing. And we have to figure out who really said it in your made-up story. That's right, little brother. Let's play.
What a mess. This'll teach me to never duplicate myself again.
What a mess! This will teach me to never duplicate myself again.
What a mess! This'll teach me to never duplicate myself again.
So who really said that in my made-up story? Was it Mr. Guinea Pig? No, Mr. Guinea Pig didn't say that in the story. Was it Daddy Dinky Doo? No, Daddy Dinky Doo didn't say it. Was it me, Pinky? Yeah, it was Pinky.
That's right.
Yay! Okay, now let's play the Great Big Fancy Word Game.
It's the Great Big Fancy Word Game.
That's my favorite.
In my made-up story, the Great Big Fancy Word was...
It means when you make a copy of something.
That's right, little brother. Okay, here's how we play. When you see a picture of the copies of me, shout out the word duplicate.
Let's try it once. Ready? Duplicate!
But when you see a picture of the real me, do this. Let's play.
Your great big fancy word.
I love making up stories. I'll bet you can make up a story too.
I want that.
Yes, they're Moo-Moo. They're Mickey. They're Moo-Moo Mickey Monsters.
All the Moo Moo Miggy monsters there are.
No, this is a whole new set. And I need them all.
I need that one, and I need that one, and I need that one.
You need them all?
That gives me an idea. Hey, I was watching that. Wait a minute. Pinky, are you gonna make up a story?
Yes, sir, Rudy Positoony.
So one day in Great Big City, Daphne Toilette was watching her TV and she saw a commercial for
Spendy Wendy, the doll who has everything as soon as you buy it for her. She's Spendy, she's Wendy, she's Spendy Wendy.
Even though Daphne had lots of toys, she never had enough. Daphne liked to accumulate a lot of things.
Wait a minute, Pinky.
I know what accumulate means. It means collecting so much of something that it piles up.
That's right, Brother Dinky Doo.
What happens next?
Let's see.
I just have to have a Spendy Wendy doll.
So Daphne ran to the biggest toy store in Great Big City.
I love you, Spendy Wendy. I'll take it.
Back home, Daphne played with her new Spendy Wendy for hours. Wendy was her favorite doll ever.
Wendy, you look kind of lonely.
It didn't take Daphne long to decide that her new doll needed something.
I know what you need. Your friends and family.
So Daphne took out her cell phone and started ordering all of Spendy Wendy's friends and family members.
Right this way, please.
There you go.
Look, Wendy! It's your best friend, Spendy Mindy.
Where shall I put these?
What are they?
More Spendy Wendy friends and family members.
Right there on the floor, please. Wendy and Mindy can't wear the same outfits all the time. They're gonna need more clothes. And they'll need a new closet for their clothes, and a new house for their closet, and a new garage for their house, and a new car for their garage.
Soon, the delivery man returned.
Spendy Wendy's fancy dresses.
And returned.
Spendy Wendy's cool closet.
And returned.
Spendy Wendy's mega mansion.
Oh! I have to call Pinky! Hi, Pinky. I'm having so much fun. I'm getting so many Spendy Wendy toys. I'm going to accumulate them all.
That's nice, Daphne. Who's Spendy Wendy?
She's just my favorite doll ever. Aren't you, Spendy Wendy? Wendy? Gotta go, Pinky!
Bye.
Wendy, where'd you go?
Spendy Wendy's jet ski. Spendy Wendy's sports car. Spendy Wendy's ocean liner. Oh, my aching back.
Woof! Daphne had sure managed to. Accumulate a lot of toys.
But now I can't find Wendy.
Hello?
Hello, Pinky. This is Daphne again. Can you come over and help me?
Help you with what?
You'll see. Please, hurry!
Okay, bye. How am I gonna get to Daphne's in a hurry? Could I ride a flappy green duck? Nah, too flappy. How about a big buzzy bumblebee? Nah, too bumbly. How about my bicycle? Perfect. So Pinky zip-zam-zoomed over to Daphne's apartment. But what you got there? Daphne? Daphne? Hello? It's me, Pinky Dinky Doo.
Pinky?
Daphne, where are you?
Under here, under the boxes. Thanks, Pinky. I was stuck under all these boxes, and I almost couldn't use my cell phone.
What's in all these boxes?
It's stuff from my new doll, Spendy Wendy. She's my favorite doll ever. But now I can't find her. She's somewhere under all these boxes. Wendy, where are you?
I'm not sure a doll needs all this, Daphne. Maybe you shouldn't accumulate any more stuff.
But you can never have too much stuff, right?
Spendy Wendy's private airport. Oh. Spendy Wendy's private runway. And Spendy Wendy's private jet plane. And I quit.
Sorry. There was way too much stuff. In fact, there was so much stuff that Daphne couldn't even find her favorite doll.
Pinky, I've got to find Spendy Wendy! Do something!
Looks like it's time for me to think big. If I have a problem, don't know which way to go, I think and think and think and think. And suddenly I know.
Come on, Pink, think!
And then it happened. Pinky had a big idea. Whee! Pinky Dinky Doo knew just what to do. Daphne, I had to think big to figure out that you need to think small.
Huh?
You don't need all the spendy stuff. You just need Spendy Wendy.
You're right. What should we do?
Let's put all this stuff in her private plane. So Daphne and Pinky put all of Wendy's friends and family members in the jet and sent them right back to the fancy toy store. And when all the boxes were gone, guess what they found?
Spendy Wendy! Thanks, Pinky. Spendy Wendy, I found you.
right. I don't need all those other toys when I have you.
And that's exactly what happened. Pretty much. The end.
I love playing with all the Moo Moo Miggy monsters I already have, so maybe I don't need all the new ones.
Good thinking, little bro.
Sounds like game time.
Say cheese, please.
Cheese, please.
Okay, let's play a game called What Came First?
What came first?
I'm going to show you something that happened in my story.
And we're going to say what came first. Yeah!
That's right, little brother. Hope you're ready to play. Okay, what happened first? Was it I had my big idea? Or was it can't find Spendy Wendy? So, what came first? My big idea? Or can't find Spendy Wendy?
Can't find Spendy Wendy. That happened before you had your big idea.
You're right. Okay, so what came next in my story? Was it we sent the toys back to the fancy toy store? Or I had my big idea? So, what came next in my story? Back to toy store or big idea? First, Daphne couldn't find Spendy Wendy. Then I had my big idea, and then we sent the toys back to the fancy toy store. And that's exactly how it happened. All right, let's play Where is Pinky?
Where is Pinky? Do you know?
Behind this yummy Swiss cheese, you're gonna see me, Pinky, in a place from my made-up story. One by one, cheese holes will pop off, like this.
And when we know where Pinky is, we shout it out.
That's right, little brother. Let's play. Where could I be? Is it Daffy's bedroom or Smack Dab Park?